Hi, I'm Lindsay Alexander, and this is my BingTracker.com. When you're a student and looking into a student checking account, there are many who have different preferences in which would be the best for them, such as whether you want access to thousands of ATMs or you would rather have a customer service-based bank. Once you finally get that checking account, hopefully it will last you all through college and maybe even the rest of your life. With that said, you'll want to look into all the details and get informed so you can choose wisely. The first important tip when choosing a branch is picking one that will hold your funds and will be convenient for both you and your parents. Branches must be available on both ends of the transactions to avoid costly fees and aggravation. So the most logical place to look would be your parents' bank. Since almost all banks allow you to link your prospective accounts, you'll be adding the convenience of online banking and eliminating fees to transfer funds from them to you. If your parents use a local credit union or a smaller bank, you should consider checking out one of the big banks which all offer student checking accounts, especially if you're going out of town for college. ATMs and branches are available around the country, so you'll have access to your bank services. Since all these banks offer similar packages, you should make sure the student checking account you choose has at least no monthly maintenance fee, no minimum balance requirements, free debit card, free ATM usage, free online banking, free check writing, and no money transfer fees. Some banks throw in all sorts of perks, like a certain amount of free foreign ATM withdrawals or unlimited check writing. These will be beneficial, but consider that nothing comes for free, so you should find out why one bank's offers are better than others. For example, if you decide to go with one of the major banks, you may not get that quality customer service you may be used to. Also, you don't want to plan on receiving any interest in your student checking account. You want your money to be working for you. You should put some into a linked savings account and only move what you need into the checking account. Either way, don't get into the habit of leaving extra money in an underperforming checking account. This is the same as stuffing it in a mattress where it earns no interest and just waits to be spent. And most banks will let your maintenance-free student checking account for up to 5 years. After that, it will automatically be converted to their standard checking account, which will definitely charge you maintenance fees and may require a minimum balance to waive them. Just make sure to read the fine print and take into account the short and long-term implications of signing up with this bank. You only want to do this once, so be thorough and take your time when looking at all your options. I'm Lindsay Alexander with MyBankTracker.com, and together we're going to build your finances and rebuild the world.